practical tips for setting up Proloquo2Go. Hi everyone, my name is Amanda Hartman and I'm a speech pathologist here at AssistiveWare. Have you just got Proloquo2Go ready to make a start? It's so exciting and a little overwhelming. Well, I'm here to help step you through some practical tips. Together, we can do this. Let's go over to the iPad now so we can see what we are doing. I have gone through the setup screens already. You might have already done this too. So I've already chosen my voice, my vocabulary, and my grid size. But eek, what next? This is exciting. I can see so many words and so many opportunities to say what I think.
I like this.
I can tap the buttons and the words are spoken out loud and go into this top message window.
I like this.
To even make that sentence. Let's look around the app. As I said, along the top, I have this message window where my words go. There is also a delete button. And you.
You. I like you.
So I can delete one single word to add another one. Or I can double tap it if I want to clear the message window. Haha. So far, so good. Here is the top toolbar. It tells me the name of the page I'm on, but it also has a share button. Next is the grid. It's filled with my 77 buttons. Many of these words are core words. Core words are the building blocks of language, and I can combine these different words to say lots of different things. And you know what? The different types of words are shown by different colors. For example, I can see lots of pink words here. They are actions or verbs. These ones along the bottom with the little tabs in the corners, they're actually called folders. When I tap these, it takes me to another page, a page filled with even more words, like here is my food page. This has some good foods on it, but I definitely will need to add some of my own favorite foods here. Lastly, let's look at the bottom toolbar. On the left is the tools pop-up. There are lots of important functions in here, which we'll look at soon. Next is the keyboard, which takes me to an alphabet. In the middle is my home button. This takes me back to the home page when I'm in a different folder. Then there is the edit pencil. I click here when I want to edit and add things to my Proloquo2Go. And last, on the bottom right corner, is the options. It's kind of a cog or a gear. This has all the background settings for within the app. And great, we found something really important in the options menu. Right at the top is the help menu. This allows me to get help right from within the app. Tap the green question mark to go to the help page. Here you have an overview which includes places where you can get more help. For example, email our support team. Our support team is so awesome, and we really want you to reach out to us if you need help anytime. When I tap on the left side, I can access different support articles. For example, search for a button. This shows me how I can search for a word. This article has a video, which will play if I'm connected to the internet, but it also has photos and a short explanation of the feature. There are lots of articles that might help you right from within the app. I will click Done in the top right corner to close the help window. So, what's my top tip to get started? Honestly, I just want you to start exploring. Explore the words, explore on your free time when you don't have any time or person demands. Open and close the folders. Figure out where the words are. Tap the words, listen to how they sound. Get yourself familiar with Proloquo2Go. All things, vehicles. I can see your new car. Oh, I'm feeling lonely. I like this. Let's do something different. Start exploring it with your person that's going to be using Proloquo2Go too. You will be learning it together. And you probably make mistakes together too, but that's fine. Who hasn't blurted out the wrong word or said something silly from time to time? Maybe as you're exploring, you were thinking about how many buttons you have on the page. I chose 77 buttons, so I have lots of words. This gives me room to learn to say a great many things. But maybe when you set up your Proloquo2Go, you choose a smaller grid size with far fewer buttons. As a general rule of thumb, we should choose the grid size based on what the person can see and touch. If I have seen somebody navigate to their favorite app on their iPhone screen, then I can know that they can see and touch smaller buttons. But let's look at some different grid sizes though. On this 7x11 grid, I will say, can we go now? This is really easy to say on the 7x11 grid because all the words are here. Now let's change the grid size. Click the options gear in the bottom right corner and then go to appearance. Here we can change the appearance of Proloquo2Go. You're looking for the view and now we're going to change the grid size. Let's try 3x5. Many people might choose 3x5 when they started because it looks simpler. Now, let's try and write the same sentence. Can home, we, people word, pronouns, we go more, describing words, now. So I have to move in and out of many folders to find the words. So we actually thought we were making it easier when we made the buttons bigger, but actually we made it harder. I have to think and work a lot harder to find the words I need. These grid sizes are good if I have difficulties seeing or touching buttons, but for many, it will really limit how they learn words to communicate. So let's go back to 7x11. Options, 7x11. What's next? Well, you need to take time to add and edit Proloquo2Go. You need to add the words that you're most likely to use for favorite people, favorite things, favorite foods, favorite places, favorite fun stuff, everything. Let's give that a go. Firstly, let's just change an existing button in Proloquo2Go. I'm going to go into the chat folder and then about me. Right now, this button says,
My name is...
I need to add my name to this. To edit the button, I tap the pencil on the bottom toolbar to go into edit mode. When you first start editing, it can be hard to remember what all the different buttons do. That's why I like this green help question mark. When I tap it, it pulls up the help overlay so I can see the different edit mode functions. To edit the name button here, I tap it. When I tap it, it gets this blue tick on it. So now I know it has been selected. So I can see the different parts of the button now. So I tap in the top text field to edit the text and add Amanda. And then I close my keyboard so I can see my symbol or picture choices. I might not like the symbol choice that it's given me. Here is the button preview. When I tap on this, I get other picture options. So let's take a picture. Remember to allow any permissions to the camera or the photos. Okay. And take a photo. Then click use the photo. And allow access to all photos. Then tap done in the top right corner to exit edit mode. Okay.
My name is Amanda.
Now we have a button edited with my name and I even added my own photo. Now let's add some more buttons. When I go to the food folder, the first hit I should get to are the food words that are my favorites or the ones I talk about the most. Then I can hit this more button in the bottom right corner of the screen to get to more foods. Look here, I have even more folders of food, a whole dictionary of foods. I've got lunch foods and snack foods and fruits and veggies, anything. Let's tip back to go back to my primary food page though. And let's add a favorite food here. I tap the edit pencil on the bottom toolbar to go into edit mode. Now I tap the plus button that's in the next free space. In this case, I tap on the left side to add a button. The text field opens automatically and asks me to type in the text to speak. This is the words that Proloquo2Go will say aloud when the button is pressed. So I'm going to type in meat pie and put the keyboard down. I can see lots of other symbol choices here, but I'm pretty happy with the first choice that they gave me. So let's add one more food. Tap the plus button and this time type pasta. Now put the keyboard down to look at the symbol choices. There are some, but I like a particular type of pasta and I know I have a photograph of it. So I tap on the button preview to get my picture options and I say choose a picture, which lets me pick a photo from my camera roll. So find the picture of the pasta, size it if I need to, and click use on the middle toolbar. And now my photo is on the button. Click done to exit edit mode. Now I can say,
I like meat pie.
Meat pies.
Where is pasta?
I can use the symbols or the pictures within the app, as well as my own photos on buttons. Now, as you were exploring the app and adding words, you start by tapping buttons to talk about what you've seen and thinking. Oh, let's get some more. We are finished. I need some help. Hey,
you
are laughing. I think you like this.
Like
you are feeling happy. You are showing where the buttons are and pointing to them as you speak, showing what they mean and how they can be used to communicate real messages in real situations. We call this modeling. We know that someone needs to see us using Proloquo2Go to learn how to use it themselves. Of course, they can explore and play with the words like we do, but they also need to see us finding and using words in the app. Sometimes I will model one or two words.
Not that.
Where is he? But sometimes I might show more words to make a sentence, like if I'm telling a story.
I hold it down. Went to her places. Party. I went to her party.
Now before we finish up, let's take a quick look again at this tools pop-up. I love that I can control my volume here. That is so easy. And I also like that I can tap typing. This gives me access to the QWERTY keyboard for when I'm learning to type to communicate. But what about this one? Oh, search. Sometimes I might be exploring and still not find a word. Search is great for this. If I tap search and then I'm going to type in the word that I'm looking for. So I like dinosaurs. Let's look for dinosaurs. So I type it in and as soon as I see the word that I'm looking for, I can tap on it. And look, it shows me the pathway. And even better, if I tap on it, it's going to guide me through the different pages to find the word. So, dinosaur is a thing. Yes, it is. Oh, it's an animal. And, it's not on the first page, so I tap more. Takes me to a whole dictionary of animal words. It's a wild animal and dinosaur. I have something to say.
I like dinosaurs. Dinosaur, I like dinosaur.
Okay. I think that's enough to get you started, and you're going to find many more resources on our website. But for now, take time to explore, find words, and add your own. And remember, take time to connect and communicate together. And please know that we are here to help. Thank you.